श्रीकृष्णा 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 गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुः साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे द्वितीयाद्वै भयं भवति बृहदारण्यक उपनिषद सेज व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ सेंस ऑफ अदरनेस दैट सेंस ऑफ अदरनेस क्रिएट्स फियर इन अवर माइंड लाइक यू नो इफ यू गो टू केरला इन केरला ओनली ओल्ड पीपल लिव बिकॉज केरला इज 100% लिटरेसी therefore 100% people are exported and those who are there they do nothing they don't allow anybody to do anything so during the summer days where it is very hot what can be done they have got you know the cement flooring they sleep and because it is hot only lungi there is no angavastra also and they sleep in the shavasana and the helipad is very weak and the lizards which are on the ceiling one lizard asked her mummy 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 should I practice landing the mummy said Don't do now, he is still awake. Right, the small little lizard, if she lands directly on the helipad, then the huge structure will be lifting itself and throw that small lizard out. The second thing, when that huge structure is lying down and because of too much of eating, Now there is no possibility of peristalsis. Peristalsis is the natural movement of the intestines required for digestion and excretion of the digested food. Because of overeating, there is a traffic jam and nothing moves inside. Therefore, people after eating too much of food, they move the hand so that you know the intestine starts moving. So when his huge hand comes and lands on his own stomach, he doesn't feel afraid. See, the small little lizard, Chipkali, and his huge hand, what is the difference between the two? The Chipkali is other than me, the hand is me. So wherever there is a sense of otherness, fear is. Wherever there is a sense of otherness, desire is. Wherever there is a sense of otherness, anger is. So the basic reason for the samsara is the sense of otherness is taken as real. And what happens in the deep sleep is only this. The sense of otherness disappears. There was one camper, he went to the, you know, for trekking and when he was going, it became suddenly very dark. He couldn't get which direction to go. So finally he decided, let me pitch my tent and be inside. So he did that. But the fear was there, lest some tiger comes and attacks and all that. So he got inside, zipped the tent all around, switch off the light, and oh God, I hope the tiger doesn't come. I hope the tiger doesn't come. Fear, fear, fear. And in that, ultimately, he slept. And when he slept, he started snoring. And when the tiger came, he got afraid and ran away. Because for the man who was sleeping, for him there was no sense of otherness. For the tiger who was alive, for him there was a sense of otherness. Therefore, the tiger was afraid, not the man. See, friends. Therefore, all the spiritual practice is to disarm the sense of otherness. And this we begin by maintaining equanimity. When joy is other than the sorrows, we will run after the joy. When the sorrows are other than the joy, we will run away from the sorrows. But when joy and sorrows are equal, then dukkheshu anudvignavanaha, sukheshu vigatasprahaha, then the joy will not make us excited and miseries will not make us miserable. So, equanimity is the beginning of spiritual life. Equanimity in dealing with the world. Name dveshosti na priyaha. Nobody is dear to me, none I hate. First, vyavaharik samatva. Equanimity at the level of our interaction with the world. Shatrau mitre putre bandhau ma kuru yatnam vigraha sandhau. When you are living in this world, don't create friends and enemies. Live in this world to leave this world, not to get buried in this world. This is the first step. Then the second step is equanimity at the level of our experiences that we go through. So first equanimity at the level of conducting business with the world. Second equanimity is at the level of our mind. When we are dealing the world, if our attention is on the equanimity of mind, then we are following the path of spiritual upliftment. If we are not taking care of our equanimity of the mind, then we are a samsari. Second. Now the third equanimity, and this is the highest. The equanimity of the highest nature is something like this. Hands are not the nose. Nose is not the head. Head is not the patella. The patella is not the back. They are different from each other. But there is one common thread which is permeating in and through. And therefore, when my hand goes and scratches my head, the head doesn't say, "Thank you, darling." And if the finger goes into the eyes don't say, "Chop him off." Because although there are differences, the one common denominator is never forgotten. This is the ultimate equanimity, and this is what is said in this mantra. Saiva sarvam yad bhutam yad cha bhavyam sanatanam jnatva tam mrutyumatteti nanya pantha vimuktaye. When objects are rejected, the sense organs don't die. When sense organs are closed, the mind doesn't die. When the mind is closed, the consciousness doesn't die. So who dies? See, friends, unless we get this thing clear in our mind, there will be always this problem. Somebody dies, somebody is not dying. See, gatasu na gatasuscha nanu shochanti pandita. Bhagwan defines a wise man. A wise man is not miserable because somebody dies and also when somebody doesn't die. In Bhagavad Gita, there are 108 jokes. If you have got the WQ, you can understand them. WQ means what? WQ means wit quotient. There are some people, they laugh at a later date. because a tube light, fused tube light. So the one reality alone is functioning in and through everything. Therefore, one of the practice of spiritual life is be happy. One day in Prempuri Ashram in Bombay, one person who comes for my lecture now and then, one day he got so annoyed. He said, "Swamiji, any topic due to you, whether the Upanishad, Bhagavad, Bhagavad Gita, Yoga Shastra, Ramayana, anything, you come back to be happy. Isn't there anything else?" I said, "No, there is anything else." "What?" "Be miserable." See, friends, unless we get this point clear, that the eyes have grossified and become the objects. So when the eyes close, there is no loss to the mind. Mind closes, no loss to the consciousness. This ladder of, it is something like, you know, imagine Bhagwan is a bubble gum eater. What the children do when they eat bubble gum? They will be chewing and then it has sufficiently become fluffy. Then, oh, and big bubble gums. It looks so ugly. Oh, but stop that. You will not throw it because you can't throw the bubble gum. Oh, exactly this is what Bhagwan does. He brings out the world and he absorbs it himself. See, friends, consciousness bubbles mind. Mind bubbles sense organs. Sense organs bubble the objective world. Water bubbles ocean. Ocean bubbles waves. How simple it is. They are not separate from each other. Tam jnatva, having known this reality, mrityumatteti, one transcends death. If we have studied Vedanta and digested it and assimilated it in our life, what will happen is this. This I told somewhere in my some talks. There was a Gujarati elderly man, I used to call him Kaka, old man. At that time I was pretty young. So somebody died, he took me there. "Swamiji, please come. We are fit for everything. When somebody dies, we go. When somebody doesn't die, we go. Swamiji, kuch karo." And we do that also. See? Nave Deshavastina Priya. So that dead body was lying there, his friend died. And the local traditions offered the flowers, did namaskar, did pradakshina. When they are alive, they will not bother about it. When dead, they do worship. Thank God, gone. That is the idea, it's the celebration. Okay. After that, when I went and sat on the chair, "Yes, Swamiji, please, say something on Gita." I said, "He is not listening." "He is not listening. And you have never heard. For whom should I talk? Keep your mouth swollen, sit for 5 minutes, go out." We went out and then he was driving. And he said, "Swamiji, now I think it's my number." I said, "Stop the car, let me get down." "You die, I have no problem." "But not when I am in the car, I will have to carry you." Then I told him, I said, "Look here, Kaka, you claim that you have been going to satsanga. You claim that you have been a devotee. You claim that you have heard Vedanta for more than my age." That time I was young. He told me this word. "Swamiji, I have been listening to Vedanta when you were not born. Then I told the Kaka, what Vedantaya heard? If having heard a news of death, if a passing thought comes about your death in your mind, or somebody else's death in your mind, you had done nothing in life. Go Maharaj. Tam nyatva mrityumatyeti. Knowing this alone, one transcends the death. And you know the best part of the death is, the death never makes anybody miserable. The one who dies, he is not miserable. Because to be miserable, you are required to be alive. When you die, you cannot be miserable. Others are miserable. That's their problem. Why you worry? And they are not miserable because you die. They are miserable. Ab kharcha aa gaya. See, friends, lead life cheerfully and happily. That is all spiritual life. Who doesn't have miseries in life? One day, this is a story in the life of Buddha Bhagwan. He went for bhiksha in somebody's house and some child was dead. So this lady came. She said, see, my child died, you know, you are Bhagwan, why don't you make my child alive? We have this funny notion. I have done so much for God. Why did I suffer? God didn't ask you to do anything. It is your own khujli that you crusted the temple. See, one person asked me this question. Swamiji, you people say God is all omnipotent and all that. He can't protect his own temples. I said, look here, temples are not of God's. Temples are that of the people. God doesn't require any temple. It is the Babaji who has got the khujli of constructing the temple. Then if you have constructed, you protect it. God doesn't require protection. Because God cannot be destroyed. See, friends. Therefore, nanya pantha ayanaya vidyate. There is no other way. Just come to discover this. And when you come back to your own self, there is nothing but joy, joy, joy. Now, when this is practiced, first of all, we practice without experience. And when you repeat something again and again, that repetition becomes expertise, expertise becomes experience. And this is the most wonderful part of our mind. Our mind can repeat the same thing without any effort. Not only ours, even the animals. See, if you have gone to village side, the animals come from the grazing from the forest. And when they come, they go to their own place without anybody telling them. And not only own place, they go and stand before their khuti, where they are tied down. And then, don't we do this thing? Take your food plate and go and sit exactly in the same seat. I am observing for last 3 days. And if somebody else is sitting in that seat, oh God, somebody is sitting in my seat. Hare Rama, Rama. Worse than the donkeys. And because of that, whenever we do anything mechanically, the charm of life is gone. Don't do anything mechanically in life. See? Mechanically, I love you, thank you. Next. Therefore, this mechanical aspect must be rejected. So finish, first of all, we practice this. What is that? 10th mantra. Sarva bhutastham atmanam.
Sarva bhutastham atmanam.
Sarva bhutani chatmani.
Sarva bhutani chatmani.
Sampashyan brahma paramam.
Sampashyan brahma paramam.
Yati nanyena hetuna. Sarva bhutastham atmanam pashyati. In and through all the things and beings, see yourself reflected in them. Now this word reflection also should be properly understood. First reflection, we all know, reflection in the mirror. Suppose there are half a dozen mirrors and you are standing in front of them, there will be half a dozen reflections. So will we have any biasness towards a particular reflection? For us, all are my own reflections. Therefore, we stand before the 3-4 mirrors in different angles. This angle, that angle, this angle. Because everywhere I am. First example of reflection. Second example of reflection is, the mother is reflected in the child. When the child is hungry, the mother feels bad. The child is having fear, the mother is also having fear. When the child is studying, these days the parents are gone so crazy because of the digitalization of parenthood. Even the names are Googled. There are no other names available. Everything Google. And therefore, the parents and the children fighting is also digital. You know how is the digital meditation? The digital Ananda is sitting and the pixels are sitting. Pixels are the disciples. And then the meditation goes on. First, delete all the cache files. Then second, rub the total history. Then the open a fresh window. And be there. Meditation. But Swamiji, what you are talking, we don't know. Humko kampu dekhke dar lagta hai. There are some people, they are afraid of computer as if it is going to bounce on you. One of the signs of not becoming old is to constantly learn, learn, learn. Anything you learn doesn't matter. Whether you use or not. Arjuna had acquired Pashupati Astra. He has never used it in his life. But because of that, he remained young. See? Keep the process of learning all through. Don't have that dejected look. Abhaji ke kya karenge? Everybody is so happy to listen to this song that this one is preparing to die. But he doesn't die. Disappointments. Learn, learn, man. So, sarva bhutastam atmanam. Seeing ourselves reflected in all the things and beings. So, the digital mother was scolding the digital child. Because the child said, Mom, you have given me username, what about the password? Because the daddy's name was not known. This can happen only in digital world. Then the mother got angry. Don't talk rubbish. I have given you birth. No, I have not downloaded you. Free download. So, the mother sees herself reflected in the child. Therefore, happiness of child is the happiness of the mother. When the examination is there, so there are some, one lady, she says, Swamiji, I wanted to come, but you know my child's examination is there. I said, which class is there? He is in class 2. Hey, Ram Ram. I said, have you studied? Yes. What was the percentage of marks you had in class 2? You don't remember that you were in class 2. But how much importance is given? Because mother sees herself reflected in the child. See. So in the joy of the child, it is the mother's joy. In the misery of the child, it is the mother's misery. Now third thing. Electrical energy is reflected as light in the bulb. Fourth understanding. A good culture is reflected in his behavior. What is the same reflection? In the same manner, when sarva bhutastham atmanam, when one is able to be happy in the happiness of others, and when one is able to extend a helping hand for the miseries of others, he alone has seen himself in all the things and beings. Bhagavad Gita, 6th chapter. See? After having told everything in yoga, then Bhagavan says, Atma upammena sarvatra samam pasyati Arjuna. Hey Arjun, he who sees himself in every being, then what will happen? Sukham va yadi va dukham. So, when the child has acquired a first position, the child is happy. More than the child, the parents are happy. Because parents see themselves reflected in the child, therefore in the happiness of the child is the happiness of the parents. He who is able to see himself reflected in all the things and beings, for him there is no reason to struggle to get happiness, because he is happy in the happiness of others. Simple technique. If you are happy in the happiness of others, you know what will happen? You don't have to struggle for happiness. One person asked me this question. Swamiji, what is the secret of your perpetual happiness? I said, this is the secret. Bhagavan's technique. Atmopammena sarvatra samam pasyati Arjuna. He who is happy in the happiness of others will be always happy. For example, when people get married, I go to attend a marriage because that is the only day of happiness. Rest of their life, their problem. And this, in this manner, I don't get jealous when others get married. I am happy. See, friends, nothing in this world can disturb you. Similarly, if somebody is miserable, then don't become miserable along with them, with the same equation. Happy in the happiness of others, miserable in the miseries of others. No. On the contrary, if you come across a miserable person, bring him out of the misery by not referring to the same miserable event again and again. Many of us have got this wrong notion. When we go and console somebody, we remind him, no, no, it should not have happened, but it happened. Now what can I do? I can only make you more miserable. Friends, I'll tell you one of my experience. I made it so many places. One old couple from Himachal Pradesh in Delhi. That time it was some very many years, 70s or earlier than that. So I used to call them Papa, Mummy. Both of them very old. And one day that lady died. I was somewhere. I got a message. I said, hey, I can't come, no, I'll come later. After 15 days, I went there. Tea, coffee, samosa, kachori, government, weather. These are the topics when you discuss, there is no sin created. We have to talk. To talk on such topics where sin and merit is not created. Suppose you talk about government. No sin, no merit created, because government is an illusion. So when you talk about illusion, there is no sin. So we talk about the other thing. And when I was going, then he said, Swamiji, you are a real Swami. I said, what mistake I have done? He said, you did not make me cry on the event of my wife's death. All other people came, they will remind me again and again that my wife died. And unless I cry, they don't feel fulfilled. And they feel, now we have done our duty, they go, leaving me crying behind. But you have not done that. Therefore, you are a real Swami. I said, I'll tell you very frankly. How do I know whether you are miserable or happy after the death of your wife? Is it obligatory that when the wife dies, the husband should be miserable? No. It is a choice. No, exercise your choice and be happy. See, friends, the day you get this principle, you understood this mantra. Sarva bhutastam atmanam, sarva bhutani chatmani. And whatever is included in the definition of I, that is not a problem for us. The moment anything is separated from the definition of I, it becomes ugly, disturbing factor. See, friends. Therefore, when our I extends to a limited area, it is called as attachment, asakti. When the I expands to the unlimited, it is called as realization. See? Therefore, when Bhagavan Krishna went to Draupadi ji and said, I am very hungry, give me something to eat. So she got angry. You are always funny. I called you for solving my problem about this and you ask me, give me something to eat. What can I give you? So Bhagavan said, give me at least that thali. And in that thali there was one grain of rice. Moral of the story, even that time also people were not clean. They could not wash their utensils properly. So if we don't wash, it is natural. So that leftover grain of rice, Bhagavan ate. And all the 60,000 rishis who went with Durvasa, all of them had an experience of satiation of their hunger. How it is possible? See, when there is a pain in your leg and you are suffering and you lie down and somebody presses your feet, ah, see, because everywhere I am. See, friends, this is what is called as God realization. Not walking in the air or walking on the water. Walking on the earth is realization. See, walking in the air, mosquitoes can do. What is great about it? Walking in the water, even the fish can do, dolphins can do that. Walking on the earth is important. See, friends. Sarva bhutastam atmanam, sarva bhutani chatmani, sampashyan. He who has thus experienced this sampashyan, then brahma paramam yati, then alone he has merged in the absolute. Na anyena hetuna, not by any other means. Kurude ganga sagara gavanam vrata paripalanam athavadanam, he has nothing to do. Agre vanni prishte bhanu ratro jubugu samarpita janu, nothing to do. Angam galitam palitam mundam dasham vihinam jatam tundam vruddho yati gruhitva dandam tadapina munchati asha pindam. This has nothing to do with your spiritual life. See, friends, unless we abide in our essential nature, all that is being done is only like going to a 5-star hotel because somebody told you, go there, yeah, the food is so wonderful. You can see everything available in the menu. So I went. I called the menu. And I read all the pages sincerely. Did parayan. Without looking at the price. And I came out and I complained, come on man, you told me when you eat that it looks wonderful, but I read the whole menu 3-4 times, I'm still hungry. Exactly the same way. Simply talking or discussing these scriptures has nothing to do. It must be our direct experience. See phrase. Sarvabhutastam atmanam sarvabhutani chatmane ikshate yoga yuktatma. See, Bhagavad Gita also says, this is the meaning of yoga. Ikshate yoga yuktatma sarvatra samadarshana. And you will see, among the tapasvis, among the yogis, among the siddha purushas, there is always an element of anger and fear. They curse. See, friends, a devotee, a jnani never curses. A devotee never curses because for him, everywhere Bhagavan, how can he curse anybody? For a jnani, he never curses because everywhere he alone is. Will my eyes curse my own finger? No. But when we are predominantly matter-oriented, I versus you, then only the cursing happens. Therefore, they are very, very angry people. You must have seen many, oh, don't go to that Mahatmaji. If he becomes angry, oh. You go to the temple not out of fear, out of love. Whenever there is an element of fear, there is a sense of otherness. Therefore, dissolving this otherness is the spiritual practice. Now, how do we proceed? We are understood theoretically and I can practice it in my own body. If there is a khushli, I will do it without saying thank you. How do we practice in our day-to-day life? Now, here the technique is given, 11th mantra. Atmanamaranim krutva pranavam chottararanim jnana nirmatana abhyasat pasham dahati panditaha. That should be pranavam. Anuswar was eaten away by the printer. Atmaram, Atmanam Aranim Krutva. See, in the traditional Vedic way, when the fire has to be invoked for offering the oblations in the fire, in the yajna, the lighter which is used for lighting the bidi is not used there. They use a specifically invoke fire. And the technique is, there is on the ground or the floor, there is a wooden cup fixed. Then there is another wooden cup which is from above, which is pressed by a brahmachari. Suppose the lower cup, upper cup, and in between there is a wooden rod. Like this. This wooden rod acts like a churning rod, mathani, churning rod. Now one brahmachari is pressing this upper cup and other brahmachari puts the rope around this wooden rod and starts churning. And when this is done, there is a friction, and because of friction, there is heat generated. So in the lower cup, where the heat is generated, there small twigs of cotton, dry leaves, they are little added. And because of the heat, they catch fire. And when that fire is invoked, then that fire is taken and put it into the yajna kunda, and there the yajna is conducted. This is the example given in this mantra. Atmanam aranim krutva pranavam chottararanim. Yourself, you are the lower cup. And uttara arani, the upper cup, is the pranava, the omkar. And in between is your intellect as the rod. And then you start churning that rod of intellect between these two points which are connected. Lower is I, the ego, upper is Om, the Paramatma. Now this is the churning going on. Atmana maranim krutva pranavam chottararanim jnana nirmathana abhyasa. Now you are doing the churning of knowledge. ज्ञान निर्मथनाभ्यास पाशम दहति पंडिता. When that fire of knowledge is born, the bondage born out of the body identification and the bondage born out of the notion of being a soul, one per body, these two bondages are burnt away in the fire of knowledge which is generated by this constant churning of knowledge. How beautiful this mantra is. आत्मानमरणिं कृत्वा प्रणवं चोत्तरारणिं ज्ञान निर्मथनाभ्यासात्. Now we have to do the churning of knowledge. Now what is the churning of knowledge to be done? Be attentive. Om has three syllables, A, U and Ma. This A, U and Ma constitutes the total creation. A is a sound which is expressed without efforts. Therefore, in every language, the first letter is A, 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 Alif, etc. No efforts are required. Simply throw the air. Then this A undergoes modifications. Those modifications are indicated by U. So, when you say no torturing of the face muscles happens. But when you say B, the lips are involved. So, then the other modifications are indicated by U. So, when you say U, you have to have a funnel type of mouth and the tongue is inside moving. Ooh. And the last sound is the labial sound. There are different types of syllables, varna, in our Sanskrit language. The vowels are A, E, I, O, U. They are in Sanskrit A, A, E, E, U, U. A, I, R, 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 I, I, O, O, A. Then the consonants are K, Varga. K, K, G, G, Ch, Ch, J, J, T, T, D, D, N, T, T, D, D, N, P, 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 M. M is a labial. After the M happens, there is no further sound possible. That is the last sound. So, A is the first sound, U is the modification of the sound, and M is the last sound. So, Om includes the total field of experience. A indicates the waking experience of the waker. U indicates the dream experience of the dreamer. Ma indicates the deep sleep experience of the deep sleeper. See, you must have seen. One day in somebody's house I was. The child came from the school, very excited. Maybe about 12 o'clock or so. School timing 10 to 11 o'clock. And by the time the child comes home, 12 o'clock. Mummy, mummy, do you know what we have studied today? Yes. Oh, you tell me. And the mummy is doctor by profession. You tell me, what is human body? So the mother said, oh, there are many physiological systems, anatomy and metabolism. What Papa says about you is right, you know nothing. Then, do you know, there is a head, there are limbs, there's a trunk. He never told this thing, you know nothing. So, he was showing hand, this is hand. So, object is indicated by the world. In the same manner, waking experience of the waker is labeled as a dream experience of the dreamer is labeled as U. The deep sleep experience of the deep sleeper is indicated as Ma. These are the total experiences that we go through. See? Now, do the manthan, do the churning of the knowledge. In every dream, there is a separate dreamer. Isn't it? In one dream, I was a beggar. In the other dream, I was a king. In the third dream, I was a terrorist. In the fourth dream, I was a husband. See? Different dreams. All of them are separate from each other. Because one dream has no relation with the other dream. If this is true with reference to dream, it is equally true with reference to the waking experience also. The day you will be able to digest this hajmola, you have taken a big leap on the spiritual path. But we mistake. Yesterday's me and today's me is the same. And because of that, we keep on referring our past. See, friends, if you take this word sincerely, not seriously, deeply you take it. I was in Varanasi and we had some talks and there was one elderly gentleman who is the editor of the most prestigious magazine published by our Gita Press, Kalyan, very prestigious magazine. And the editor of that thing is a very nice gentleman, very close friend also, elderly man, must be 80 plus. So he asked me, he said, Swamiji, last 2-3 days I am observing, you are again and again insisting, don't talk about your past. Unless we talk, how will our children know what happened in the past? I asked them, you talk, no problem. No, why you insist? I said, I am insisting from the spiritual sadhana point of view. First of all, which children want to know about their parents' childhood? Nobody wants. It is the parents who go on forcing their childhood on their children. See? When we were children, we used to go without shoes to the school. But these days, children want every now and then new shoes. And one child was very smart and his father told. And after the child told, the father said, Swamiji, you have spoiled my child. I said, not only that, your wife is also spoiled. She doesn't take you seriously. The child said, Dad, your dad was a poor guy. My dad is rich. Why are you jealous? So first of all, nobody wants to know about our childhood. What is childhood is past. Now everybody is interested in their own future. And we the oldies have no future. We have got only the past. See? So what we can do? We can persecute the younger generation by our past. Jab hum chote the, are yaar, who cares? See, friends, number one. Number two. Childhood belongs to whom? To you or to the body? Think. When the childhood belongs to the body and you are all the time talking about your childhood, that means you are not ready to give up your body identification. And that is the main culprit. Unless we give up body identification, we have not taken one single step on the spiritual path. See, friends, And therefore, one of the technique is this. Don't talk about your past and don't ask about their past. This is spiritual practice. But if you are, you know, happen to dash with old couple, then you have to, in a social structure, you have to talk to them. So what to do in such conditions, listen. You ask them about their past and don't listen. See? So they are kept busy and their business is so wonderful. Whatever the husband says, the wife has to contradict. Whatever the wife says, the husband has to contradict. If the husband says, I think when we went to Panchgani, what Panchgani? It was Panchmani. Okay, Panchmani. And you have good entertainment, free cartoon show without, you know, TV around. Therefore, A indicates waking, U indicates dream, and M indicates deep sleep. Now find out whether you are the same dreamer in all the dreams or there were separate dreamers in each dream. Second thing, whether you are the same waker in all the waking experiences or for every waking experience there is a separate waker. Has anybody ever written autobiography of a dreamer? You cannot, because there is no continuity. Exactly the same way, in the waker also, there is no continuity. Every waking experience, waker is born, waking experience over, waker dies. See, when the dream experience, dreamer is born, and he got a lot of money through some lottery, and when he went to collect the money, for whatever reason, the dream breaks. Will the waker cry, oh poor dreamer, lost every money? No. Think in the same manner. When we wake up from this waking dream, that fire of waking up from the waking dream, he is mentioned here. Jnananir Mathana Vyasa Pasham Dhati Pandita. Then you continue to be the waker, but don't suffer as a waker. You continue to live through the body, but don't suffer as the body. You continue to live through the mind, but never suffer as the mind. You continue to sleep, but you are always awake. That is our essential nature. See, friends, unless we think exhaustively, completely, our knowledge will not be valid. If somebody says, I am healthy, my one leg is elephantiasis, other leg is polio, so on an average they are normal. There is no average in that. In the same manner, when I am alone, I am happy, but when she is around, I am very miserable. Then you are always miserable. See, friends, when our happiness is not dependent on anything, if you are happy in spite of your wife, then you are a genius. See, friends, therefore, Atmana Maranim Krutva Pranavam Chottararani Jnana Nirmatana Vyasa Pasham Dhati Pandita. And Pasha, the bondage, is only of the wrong notions. First wrong notion, I am the body. Second wrong notion, I am the mind. Third wrong notion, whatever I think is right. We do not want to change ourselves. See, friends, one simple thing I'll tell you, try to catch it. Take every single experience of your life as a spiritual examination. Every experience, wherever you are. in a hotel, interacting with the sweeper, talking to the manager on the airport. Everywhere, every experience is a spiritual examination. See? And when with examination, you can't complain. More difficult area. Mummy, mummy, they have asked everything out of syllabus. You can't do that. You have to be alert 24/7. Otherwise, you simply go on complaining and nothing will help you. And to be a regular student facing the examination, what is the criteria? We are always alert 24/7. 100% alertness. You know, the accidents happen never by those who are learning the car. When they are learning the car, if other car is coming and it is 5 miles away, he goes out of the road. And those who have been driving many years, after some time, they start taking things for granted in their life. Every accident happens when we start taking the things granted in life. Every moment is absolutely 100% alertness. See? So, if the alertness goes down, then we again boil down to the same little miserable entity. What is there for you to say all the time, be happy, get married and show, be happy. So, such people who are miserable and they justify their miseries, they are samsari. Samsari means unnecessarily you caught hold of samsari. You became a samsari. Therefore, stop that complaining attitude. Wherever we are in the right place. Whatever is happening to us, it is exactly required for our evolution. Bhagavad Gita says, Uddharedatmanatmanam natmanam avasadaye. We are here for our evolution. See. And when evolution is understood, evolution is living the earlier state and progressing towards the next higher state is evolution. And in evolution, death is an imaginary point. The seed, when it is evolving, the death of the seed is the birth of the germinated, plant. The death of the plant is the tree. Then the death of the tree is the flower. The death of the flower is the fruit. The death of the fruit is again the seed. Where is death? But we get caught up in one small little thing and imagine this is all. There is no cul-de-sac, there is no reverse gear on the spiritual path. Charaiveti, charaiveti. With this attitude we live, then only the fire of knowledge has kindled. Don't imagine fire of knowledge means when you are walking, all the smoke will start coming out. Then you are smoking. Fire of knowledge is that wherein, in spite of the difficulties, you keep your wits alive. You are not miserable. Next mantra we'll read and see it in the next class. Sa eva maya parimohitatma.
Sa eva maya parimohitatma.
शरीरमास्थाय करोति सर्वम् स्त्रियन्न पानादि विचित्र भोगैः स एव जाग्रत् परितृप्तिमेति स्वप्ने स जीवः सुख दुःख भोक्ता स्वमायया कल्पित जीवलोके सुषुप्ति काले सकले विलीने तमो विभूतः सुखरूपमेति पुनश्च जन्मांतर कर्मयोगात् स एव जीवस्वपिति प्रबुद्धः पुरत्रये क्रीडति यश्च जीवः ततस्तु जातं सकलं विचित्रम् आधारमानन्दमखण्डबोधम् यस्मिन् लयं याति पुरत्रयं च एतस्माज्जायते प्राणो मनः सर्वेन्द्रियाणि च कं वायुर्ज्योतिरापः पृथिवी विश्वस्य धारिणी यत्परं ब्रह्म सर्वात्मा विश्वस्यायतनं महत सूक्ष्मात् सूक्ष्मतरं नित्यम् तत्त्वमेव त्वमेव तत् जाग्रत्स्वप्नसुषुप्त्यादि प्रपञ्चं यत्प्रकाशते तद्ब्रह्माहमिति ज्ञात्वा सर्वबन्धैः प्रमुच्यते त्रिषु धामसु यद्भोग्यम् भोक्ता भोगश्च यद्भवेत् तेभ्यो विलक्षणः साक्षी जिन्मात्रोऽहं सदाशिवः मय्येव सकलं जातम् मयि सर्वं प्रतिष्ठितम् मयि सर्वं लयं याति तद्ब्रह्माद्वयमस्म्यहम् अणोरणीयानहमेव तद्वत् महानहं विश्वमहं विचित्रम् पुरातनोऽहं पुरुषोऽहमीशो हिरण्मयोऽहं शिवरूपमस्मि अपाणिपादोऽहमचिन्त्यशक्तिः पश्याम्य चक्षुः शृणोम्य कर्णः अहं विजानामि विविक्तरूपो न चास्ति वेत्ता मम चित् सदाहम् वेदैरनेकैरहमेव वेद्यो वेदान्तकृत् वेदविदेव चाहम् न पुण्य पापे मम नास्ति नाशो
न पुण्य पापे मम नास्ति नाशो
न जन्म देहेन्द्रिय बुद्धिरस्ति न भूमिरापो न च वह्निरस्ति न चानिलो मेऽस्ति न चाम्बरञ्च एवं विदित्वा परमात्मरूपम् महाशयं निष्कलमद्वितीयम् समस्त साक्षिं सदसद्विहीनम् प्रयाति शुद्धं परमात्मरूपम्। ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरिः ओम्।